As lawmakers debate the president over how to end the partial government shutdown, its effects are being felt across the nation and right here in the nation's capital. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi has been speaking to people who have been affected. He joins us now. Good evening, Jason.
Good evening, Lauren. The shutdown stalemate inside that building is leading to quite a mess outside. Literally, those trash bins here on National Park Service land were overflowing with junk. Because of the shutdown, the District of Columbia stepped in to remove that trash, but still this shutdown is creating quite a mess for tourists.
From China.
It's just so disappointing. I want to go in there, but it's just closed.
And Italy.
We paid for the airfare, we paid for the hotels, the restaurants, for everything, for the taxis, for transportation. And we come here and we don't see what we're looking for. You know, this is really, really bad.
Tourists disappointed by these signs posted on D.C.'s popular Smithsonian museums. Gina from Miami wanted to show her children the National Museum of African American History.
It's just something that we really want to embrace and cherish and show the kids. And this is something dear to my heart. It breaks my heart that this is closed because of the government shutdown. It's just ridiculous. But it is what it is. What can we do?
The 12th day of the partial government shutdown is the first day these doors have been locked. Stayed open through Christmas by using prior year funds. But the Smithsonian can no longer keep it open until Congress passes new funding. Trash piles up as national park workers stay home. Enrico Iacomini tells me it shouldn't come to this.
If you have a political dispute, you don't close the whole country to local people and to visitors.
Unlike previous shutdowns, even with little staff on duty, the Trump administration leaves some national parks open, closing others. Park spokesman Jeremy Barnum says they'll close any area where garbage or other problems become a threat to health and safety.
The 116th Congress gavels in tomorrow. Democrats say in the House they're going to pass a bill to reopen the government. Lauren?
What else do Democrats have in store as they take control of the House tomorrow? I know you'll be right up there interviewing them.
That's right. First thing will be the reselection of Nancy Pelosi to be the next Speaker of the House. We're expecting that tomorrow. And then the next thing they're going to do is pass a rules package to change some of the rules in the House chamber. One of those rules is interesting. It will allow headgear to be worn on the House floor. This is to allow a Muslim from Minnesota to wear her headscarf. Lauren?
Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi. Thank you, Jason.